press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, let us continue with the next main in the exercise 4.4. Find the values of k. Find the value of k for each of the following quadratic equation so that they have two equal roots. See, they have given the condition that the given quadratic equation has two equal roots and they are asking you to find out the roots. They are asking you to find out the value of k. Okay, and the condition is that they have equal roots. So I hope you understood the meaning of equal roots. So in the previous class we had discussed what is the meaning of equal roots, what is the meaning of two distinct roots, and no real roots exist. Okay, three conditions I had told you. So what is the condition for the equal roots? If the quadratic equation have equal roots, then what is the condition? You all know that b square minus 4ac, that is discriminant, should be 0. Okay, so let us try to solve this problem. First one, 2x square plus kx plus 3 is equal to 0. 2x square plus kx plus 3 is equal to 0. So you all know this quadratic equation has two equal roots. You have to find out the value of k. So how to proceed? Just observe. See, we know that for equal roots, b square minus 4ac should be equal to 0. Correct? We know that b square minus 4ac should be, for equal roots, b square minus 4ac should be equal to 0. So what is b? A is 2 and b is k and c is 3. Now b square minus 4ac means b square, that is k square minus 4 into a c, correct, is equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. According to the condition, it should be 0. That is k square minus 4 to the 8 3 is 24 should be equal to 0. K square minus 24 should be equal to 0. Now then, what is k? Now you all know k square is 24, therefore k is equal to plus or minus root of 24. So what is the value of k? K can be plus or minus root of 24. Means root of 24, it can be simplified, you all know. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, no, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8 3s are 24. So this is root of 24. Root of 24 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now this can be simplified as, so you all know this can be taken out root 6. I hope you know to simplify this. So finally, what will be the value of k? K will be plus or minus 2 root 6. So either it can be plus 2 root 6 or minus 2 root 6. Okay, is it clear? So this is how we can find out the value of k when the condition is given. So this quadratic equation has two equal roots. So when the condition is given, we can find out the value of k. Okay, so this is one question. So the next one, so the second one, we have kx into x minus 2 plus 6 is equal to 0. Now let us try to find out. See, when the equation is given like this, tried to convert into the standard form. See, it is not in the standard form. This you have to simplify it. So this will be kx into x is kx square minus 2kx plus 6 is equal to 0. Okay. Now k, now when you compare, so like this, okay, again you write, we know that for 2, for 2 or for equal roots, what is the condition? For equal roots, what is the condition? B square minus 4ac should be equal to 0, since they have given in the question that this is having equal roots. Okay. Now, I hope you understood. See the difference between the first main and the second main. See, first main is that we need to find out whether the roots, whether they are having distinct roots, equal roots or no real roots. But in the second main, they have given that these quadratic equation have equal roots. So we know the condition for equal roots, b square minus 4ac. Using this, we can find out the value of k, okay, which satisfy the equation, that is b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. Now what is b square? B is equal to A is equal to k, b is equal to minus 2k. So note, very important, a is k and b is minus 2k and c is 6. Okay. Now here b square means 2k whole square minus 4 into a is k, 6 should be equal to 0, correct? So what will be the answer there? Now this will become 2 to the 4k square minus 6 4 the 24k is equal to 0, correct? Now 4k square is equal to 24k. Now k square is equal to, or k is equal to, you can do like this also, find out the value of k. How will you find out? See here, 4 into k, I'll take to the denominator 4k. Just observe carefully, or kk can be cancelled, 1k and here 1k cancelled. So 4k is equal to 24. And k is equal to 24 by k, correct? So 4 ones are 4, 6 are 24, k cancel. So k is equal to 6 is the answer. K is equal to 6 is the answer. Now see here, k is equal to 6 is the answer for the second one. I hope you understood. So only two questions they have given, and let us move on to the next problem, that is third one. Okay, this is to find out the value of k. Okay, let us move on to the next main, that is exercise 4.4, third one. Is it possible to design a rectangular mango grove whose length is twice its breadth and the area is 800 meter square? If so, find the length and the breadth. See, they are asking you, is it possible to have a rectangular garden with the length? See, whether it is possible. Means it is nothing but, see, we can compare this type of question to the first main. See, they had asked you to find out the nature of the roots, correct? If they exist, then you find out the roots they had given. The same way, so you have to find out. So now, let us consider, let the breadth of a rectangular mango grove as x. And what data is given there? Length. So what will be the length of the mango grove? Length of the rectangular mango grove be, length let it be twice the breadth, so 2x, correct. And what else is given? Area is given. Area of the rectangular mango grove is given, that is 800 meter square. Yes. Now formula to find out the area of the rectangle, you all know, L into B. See, rectangle, if the rectangular groove is there, then area is equal to L into B. You all know, to find out the area, we use the formula A is equal to L into B. Now area is how much? 800 is equal to L. What is the length? 2x into x. Therefore this equation becomes 2 into x is 2x square is equal to 800, correct. Now this is a quadratic equation. Now we have, so let us find out x square is equal to 800 divided by 2. So 2 ones are 400. Next we have 400. So x is equal to plus or minus root of 400, correct. X is equal to plus or minus root of 400. So x is equal to plus or minus 20. So here definitely it cannot be negative, you all know. So breadth, what is the breadth of the conclusion? What is the breadth of the rectangular groove? Is x, that is plus 20. Then what is the length? What is the length of the rectangular groove? It is, length is 2 into x, that is 2 into 20. So this is meter. So 2 into 40 meter. So one is length is 40 meter and breadth is 20 meter. When L into B, when you multiply L into B, you will get 800, correct. Area, see, 4 2s are 8, 2 zeros. So 800 is the area. So our answer is correct. Yes or no? Correct. Because listen, one more important to be noted, that see, they have given in the page number 92 a note to the reader. See, in the case of word problems, the obtained solution should always be verified with the condition of the original problem and not in the equation formed. See, this is very, very important for the students to note. Here, always, whenever you get the answer, we will do verification. I told you, in each and every chapter, I'll be telling you that verification is important. Wherever possible, you do the verification, correct? So here, 200, see, length, breadth is 20 and length is 40. So when L into B, you all know, L into B is 800. So instead of putting the value x here in the formed quadratic equation, better always go for the original equation. Means when you see the question, when you read the question, you will get that area is 800 meter square. So with this you make the conclusion there, or you have to find out the verification there. See, not with the framed equation. So that is very, very important. Suppose if you have written the equation wrong and you try to put the value here somewhere in the equation, so again you may go wrong. This leads to the wrong information for you people. So better always go with the original question. When read the question and try to get the verification there itself, okay? Try to put the value of x in the original, I mean in the question. When you read, you will get the answer. So let us move on to the next problem. See, is the following situation possible? If so, determine their present ages. The sum of the ages of two friends is 20 years. 4 years ago, the product of their ages in the year was 48. See, the sum of the ages of the two friends is 20 years. So, this situation, is it possible? You have to find out. So, let us write the equation and then find whether it is possible or not. Okay. So, now let the age of one friend, okay, so two friends, they have not given the name, so one friend be x, okay, let the age of one friend be x. Now the other friend's age, what will be the other friend's age? Then let the age of other friend or the second friend, you can take like this, first friend, second friend also you can take, the other friend be 20 minus x. I hope you all know this by now, you are familiar with the to write the equation, because this age problem we have done in the previous exercise also, okay. So the sum of the age is 20, so 20 minus x years. Then what else they have given, the conditions there? 4 years ago, the product of their ages in the years was 48. 4 years ago. So this is the present age. Let the present age also you can write. Okay, both of them. Then 4 years ago. 4 years ago. That first friend's age. Their ages was x minus 4. See, one friend is having x minus 4. You all know why. This present age is x. 4 years ago means you have to subtract 4 from the present age. Correct? Next. Then this will be 20 minus x minus 4. Correct? 20 minus x minus 4. So, this will become, you all know, 20 minus x minus 4. So, 16 minus x. So, the age will be, this will be 16 minus x. Correct? Then, the product of their age is, in the years was 48. So, the product. So, product means here, x minus 4 and the other one is 60 minus x, the product is 48, correct? Now, let us find out, let us try to solve this equation and let us see whether this situation is possible or not, okay? Now, see x into 16x minus x square. Here minus 64, 16, 4 is a 64, minus into minus plus 4x minus 48 is equal to 0. Now here minus x square, then plus 16 plus 20x, then here minus 12, 112, correct? 8 plus 4, 12, 1, 10 plus 11 is equal to 0. Minus x square plus 20x minus 112 is equal to 0. Now I don't want to take minus here, so I'll change the sign. How I will change the sign? By dividing whole throughout by minus 1. So this will become x square by dividing the whole by minus 1. This will become x square. This will become minus 20x, and this will become plus 112 is equal to 0. Now, whether it is possible or not, I told you in the when we did the previous exercise, previous main, the previous class. See here, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 20, and c is equal to 112. Now, b square minus 4ac will be equal to b square minus 20 whole square, correct? Minus 4 into a is 112. So, here this will become 400 minus 4 to the 8, 4 on the 4, 4 on the 4. See here, 400 minus 448. See here, this will become minus 48, which is less than 0. Less than 0, minus 48, less than 0. So, to what conclusion you can come? So, you can come to the conclusion that this does not have real roots, means this situation is not possible. This situation is not possible. You read the question, at the beginning they have asked, is the following situation possible? So, what you have to write? Since since b square minus 4ac is less than 0, the above situation or the above quadratic has no real roots. Therefore, the above situation is not possible. The above situation is not possible. I hope you understood. You have to write the conclusion like this. Above situation is not possible because it does not have real roots. Okay. Now, one more let us find out the last one. Last one, whether the condition is okay, we'll find out whether the possible design to rectangular park, whether it is possible with that situation. Is it possible to design a rectangular park of perimeter 80 meter and area 400 meter square? If so, find the length and the breadth. So, they have given the perimeter and they have given the area. Okay. So, let us find out. Let us find out, let the length of rectangular park be x. Let us take it as x. They have not given, but we can take it as x. And what else they have given? Perimeter. Perimeter. You all know 2 into L plus B. Perimeter is equal to 2 into L plus B of rectangle, the formula, correct? Now, perimeter they have given. We have L. Perimeter is how much? The question? 80 meters, correct? And area also they have given. Now, area is equal to L into B. Okay. Now, area is how much? Area is 400 is equal to L. We have taken it as X into B. So, what is B? What is B? B is equal to 400 by X. Do you agree? B is equal to 400 by X. Correct? Now, can we put this here? So that all the terms will be x, so it will be easy for us to work out. So p is equal to, next, p is equal to 2 into l. What is l? Length is x we have taken, and what is b? B is 400 by x. And what is p? According to the question, perimeter they have given 80 meters. Perimeter is 80 is equal to 2 into x plus 400 by x. Now I think you know how to solve this. See, by using area, listen carefully once again. See, directly we are not getting the quadratic equation. See, area we have, by the known data we have to frame the quadratic equation. Now here we have area. Area is equal to L into B, correct? Area is how much? 400 is equal to L. I had taken it as X. We don't know B because they have not given the comparison. See, in the previous problem, they had given length is equal to 2 times the breadth. So there was a relationship between length and breadth. But in this case, we don't have. So what we have to do is, by using the given data, we have to find out. So here area is equal to L into B. So area is X into B. Now, B is equal to 400 divided by X. 400 divided by X. Now, again you have to put this perimeter. P is equal to 2 into, here L means how much? L is X plus B means 400 by X. Now, perimeter we know, 80. 80 is equal to 2 into X plus 400 by X. Now, here 80, so this I am going to transpose here. So, this will become 40, correct? 40 is equal to, now I will continue here. 40 is equal to, by transposing this 2, it will become 40. 40 is equal to X plus 400 by X. And you all know, we'll take the LCM. X is the LCM. Now this will be 1. You all know how to take the LCM. And 1. So 1 into X is X. X into X is X square. Plus 400 is equal to 40. Now cross multiply. This you have to cross multiply. So this will become 40X is equal to X square plus 400. So, if you bring it to the standard form, this will become X square plus 400 minus, okay. So, we can write like this. We will write in the standard form, X square minus 40X, X square minus 40X plus 400 is equal to 0. Now, before finding the roots, let us see whether it is having real roots or not, okay? So, for that what you have to do? Here, A is equal to 1, B is equal to minus 40 and C is equal to 400. Now, B square minus 4AC is equal to, B square means 40 into 40, minus 40 square, then minus 4 into A means 1, into 400. Correct? Now, this will be 4 4s are 16. So, 1600 minus 4 4s are 16. So, 1600 minus 1600. So, definitely it is 0. And you all know, shall I continue here? I'll continue here. See, now it is 0, means definitely it is having equal roots, but sorry, it has having real roots, but equal, they are equal roots. So, what shall we write here? Let us find out. Therefore, since b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, x is equal to, so I hope you can remember this formula, minus b by 2a, correct? Equal roots can be found out by this formula, correct? So, x is equal to minus b. Now, just see here, minus b means here plus 40 divided by 1, 2 into a, sorry, 2 into 1, correct? So, this will become 20. So, x is equal to 20, x is equal to 20, correct? 20 meter. Therefore, length of the rectangular park, length of the rectangular park is how much? 20 meter. And breadth of the rectangular park also, how much? How we can find out? See, you can apply in any one of the equation. Sorry, here, okay, two equal roots. So, we have two equal roots here, 20. So, 20 into 20, area, what is the area they have given here? Length into breadth. See, you can find out from this also, see. We have area how much? Area is 400 is equal to 20, b is equal to, b if you want to find out area by 20 means 20 only, so both are 20, so find out 20 into 20, so area will be 20 into 20, 400 meters. So, square, so if you ask me, length and breadth is same. So, it is a square only, and rectangle is also a type of square, isn't it? So, we can 20 and 20 meters. So, length is 20 meter and breadth is also 20 meter. I think by this, we completed this chapter, and practice well, so that, see, linear equation in two variables and continuously we have done this quadratic equation also. So, all these are very very interesting chapters. So, practice well, and as usual you work out the example problems, definitely it will help you in solving the exercise problems, or to know extra knowledge also, you will gain extra knowledge by solving the example problems. So, try to work out, practice well. Thank you. Let us meet in the next chapter. Thank you.